Hey friends, hey Jonathan. Wednesday season 2 is about to begin filming in a month, so I thought it'd be the perfect time to dive back into the kooky world of Wednesday to figure out which episode from season 1 was the best. This video is going to be split into 3 sections. First, I'm going to give a brief synopsis of the show. Then in the second section, we're going to start eliminating episodes that don't quite cut it for the title of best. Then in the third section, we're going to finally reveal and talk about the best episode of Wednesday. And before we start, this is all of course just my personal opinion. Not that Wednesday would care. Section 1, Synopsis. Wednesday follows the story of Wednesday Adams, a smart and twisted outcast who gets transferred to Nevermore Academy after committing an act of violence in her previous school. There, she meets other outcasts like herself and is thrusted headfirst into all kinds of situations and relationships. However, things take a quick turn for Wednesday as she finds herself in the center of a centuries-old mystery that threatens to destroy the lives of outcasts like herself. There are 6 secrets hidden deep within Nevermore Academy and the town of Jericho, but Wednesday's been surrounded by sick things all her life, and she enjoys this kind of thing. So she makes it her mission to uncover the mysteries of Nevermore and Jericho, all while navigating her new, eccentric relationships at Nevermore Academy. Season 1 has 8 episodes that run for about 50 minutes each, and we're gonna whittle them down bit by bit to find out which episode I personally think is the best. Section 2, Elimination. Right away, episodes 3, 6, 7, and 8 are gonna be removed from the race. After rewatching the entire series twice, I've come to the conclusion that the best episode of Wednesday should be one that strikes a balance between its 2 most important components, the characters and the mysteries. Focus too much on the characters and the show feels stagnant. Focus too much on the mysteries and the show loses its soul. And unfortunately, episodes 3, 6, 7, and 8 suffer from the latter. The heart and soul of this series, in my opinion, are the characters from Nevermore, the outcasts. I think they are more well-written and engaging than the quote-unquote normie characters. And while episodes 3, 6, 7, and 8 are charming in their own way, they focus a little too much on engaging the audience with the mysteries that the outcasts themselves don't get enough time to interact with each other in meaningful ways, resulting in less interesting episodes that are focused on less interesting normie characters. Additional reasons as to why these 4 episodes didn't make the cut are that episode 3 is a little slow, with most of the episode consisting of the characters doing volunteer work. Episode 6 is a little too dark. A lot of bad things happen to the characters in this episode, but if you like that kind of thing, you'll love this episode. Episode 7 is all about Wednesday making the wrong moves, which makes it a little frustrating to watch. And episode 8 is good, but Joseph Crackstone lets it down. That man is a goofy, one-dimensional villain. And for those reasons, episodes 3, 6, 7, and 8 are out. But on the bright side, episodes 1, 2, 4, and 5 are still in. And these episodes are more enjoyable in my opinion because they focus more on the characters, the outcasts specifically. As enjoyable as they are though, the elimination process must continue, and the next 2 episodes to leave are episodes 2 and 5. As previously mentioned, the best episode of Wednesday should strike a balance between its characters and its mysteries. And while episodes 2 and 5 give us a lot of time with the characters that we love, they slightly lose sight of the mystery component of the show. Episode 5 is great. Most of this episode is about Wednesday's parents, Morticia and Gomez Adams. They're outcasts, just like Wednesday, which means that they're generally more well-written characters, and thus, this was a very entertaining episode. At the same time, this felt very much like a filler episode. In fact, the whole point of this episode is to sidetrack Wednesday's main investigations. The killers literally gave Wednesday a side case to solve in order to stall her, so it very much felt like and is kind of intended to be a filler episode. Although to the episode's credit, the side case did end up tying into the main mystery even though some parts of it were a little convoluted. Nevertheless, after watching the episode, although it was very enjoyable, you can't help but feel like it veered a little too far from the main mysteries, and for that reason, episode 5 is unfortunately out. Very good episode though, and remember, all of these episodes have something good about them, but we're here to find the best of the best. And while episode 2 is close, it doesn't quite make the cut. It too veers off from the main mysteries of deciphering the picture from the purple book and figuring out what the monster is and why it's killing people. Instead, we get this new little side mystery about how Rowan is still alive after being killed just an episode ago. It's still pretty interesting, but it's not really related to the main mysteries. And the only progress Wednesday makes in her investigation is entering the Nightshade's library and retrieving the purple book. However, episode 2 is still very high on my list because of one big bright point. The Poe Cup. This was awesome. It was so flavorful and fun to see the Nevermore students all in one place, dressed up in costumes, using their powers, and competing with each other. What's not to love about that? The Poe Cup single-handedly solidified episode 2 as season 1's third best episode. It gave us a lot of time with the characters that we love, but it took it a little slow on the mystery front. So, in our quest to find the best season 1 episode, we're looking for an episode that packs as much flavor as episode 2 while providing more mystery. I present to you episode 1, Wednesday's Child is Full of Woe. This episode is really good. It's the only time that we get to see Wednesday's previous school, Nancy Regan High School. Even though it was very brief, I loved seeing how different Wednesday was to everyone in that high school. And of course, later on, this episode gave us many iconic scenes, like the piranha pool scene, Enid's dancing scene, and Wednesday's violin playing scene. This is the only episode where we get to see the fencing room. It's one of the few times we get to see Lurch. It's a very funny episode and the soundtrack is on point as well. The dialogue in this episode is especially witty, and it does all of this while setting up a bunch of interesting mysteries. It's really good, but it's not the best. Because the normie characters unfortunately get a decent amount of screen time in this episode, and since they're not as well written, sequences that involve them are just not as compelling to watch, so that pulled down the episode for me. However, this then leads us to the important conclusion that the best episode of Wednesday should ideally feature the outcast characters as much as possible and the normie characters as little as possible, and should also ideally be a well-rounded episode that not only allows the characters to meaningfully interact with each other, but also have a compelling and focused mystery plotline as well. And no other episode does that better, Section 3, The Reveal, than Episode 4. Whoa, what a night. This is the most well-rounded episode in my opinion. It gives us the most good things while also giving us the least not-so-good things. It's a super enjoyable episode that is filled with humor and character exploration. This is the only episode where Tyler and Xavier ever talk to each other. It was very brief, but they did talk to each other. This is also the only episode where Tyler is inside Nevermore. This is the first time we get to see the Raven, which is like their version of prom. The costume changes are refreshing and everyone looks dapper. It really does feel like a special occasion. This is the episode where Ajax and Enid kiss for the first time. This is the episode where we make significant progress in the monster mystery and find a potential culprit in Xavier. This is the episode where Eugene almost gets killed by the monster. And this is the episode that gave us the iconic Wednesday dance scene. This episode gives the characters time to settle down and have fun with each other, to talk to each other, to confide in each other. It's the most well-rounded episode in my opinion, full of mysteries but also character exploration. The normie characters mostly take a back seat in this episode and allow the outcast to shine. If I were to only recommend one episode of Wednesday to someone, it would be this one. Wednesday is a fascinating show with something charming in every episode, but if I had to choose the best of the best, it would be episode 4. That being said though, while episode 4 is my favorite episode, I think episode 6 has the best ending, so I'll leave you with that. Thank you for watching, my friends. I hope you have a wonderful day.
We all seem to be connected like a spider's web. And when Mayor Walker got too close to the truth, he was silenced. but I won't be. So whoever's watching me, know this. I will find you.